thanks, everyone, and it's great to be here. I feel, I guess I'm the undercard to President Obama coming along. There's some dogs back there looking at me right now saying, you know, let's move along here. So I wanted to point out, I wanted to kind of wrap up this day. I am the last speaker a little bit with, get a little local, right? So we've heard a lot about some really great stuff that technology companies and organizations and institutions around the world are doing, around our country are doing, all around DC, et cetera. But right here in Northern Virginia, there's a heck of a lot of things going on. In fact, Virginia itself as a state is very, very interested in becoming, frankly, the big data capital or the data analytics capital of the US, if not the world, right, obviously. And you hear our governor, McLaughlan, talking about that. There's a quote that he had at a opening of a new data center out in Data Center Alley in Loudoun County. There's also some perspective from the leadership of our Big Data and Analytics Committee at the Northern Virginia Technology Council about how important the domain expertise is in this region to the big data capabilities we can generate and the economic development that can occur from this, from the workforce here. As an architect, though, when I hear things like big data and data architect, you know, you've seen a bit of a picture kind of like this before in some other presentations earlier, but fundamentally it's about finding the data, getting the data, managing and protecting it, and you can't see it, but using and sharing it down here. So it's a bit of a life cycle. And that life cycle applies to just about any kind of information asset management or information domain. So how do you get started in this? What part of this is big data? You know, how many people out there are data scientists? You know, I heard maybe one or two, a couple out there. You know, how many people out there are actually doing big data? Well, there's a handful. You know, I'd like to propose that here in Northern Virginia, we are all either doing or equally capable of getting into and performing activities that supplement and promote the big data industry. If I overlay areas of this information architecture, and by the way, this is a reference architecture from Oracle that's fairly similar to most technology companies underneath, but big data requires the services and expertise of everybody in the information management lifecycle, from device and signal engineers to information publishers, cybersecurity administrators, web mobile programmers. You know, everybody, every role, every job in the information technology industry in, you know, around the world, but particularly in Northern Virginia, you know, has a role to play or can have a role to play in big data, or learn to become one of these. And I'm speaking a little bit to maybe the students. Maybe there's a couple students left out there, I guess. So it's not just Hadoop specialists. It's not just data scientists. It's not just DBAs. Everybody has a role to play in big data. But how do we get there? How do you start? Well, one of the organizations out there that's working very closely in Northern Virginia with all, basically all the universities in the area and some other institutions and technology companies, the NVTC, is starting to take a stab at that. They see that there's a significant work, a talent gap in the workforce, and the state of Virginia recognizes this as well. Last spring, as part of the Big Data and Analytics Committee, this committee started taking a stab at, okay, so if we map the kinds of degrees that you might get and colleges around the area are developing to the categories of the workforce involved in big data, the kinds of roles involved, from data management to infrastructure to fusion, basically bringing it all together or staging, to visualization and then policy and ethics, a lot of which you heard in the last presentation. You know, how do we as academic institutions, as companies that are looking to both develop workforces and hire peoples, and as government institutions to internally develop and then look to outsource these capabilities, how do we educate those folks in the kind of roles that we've got a gap in for the big data? And so some of this work has started to develop. It's far from complete, obviously, but a lot of it you're starting to see show up in local academic institutions like GMU. There's courses available. There's more courses available with Virginia Tech and UVA and others in the region. And companies as well are working together in forums and collaborative initiatives like this to identify and put forward and demonstrate to both the community, the workforce, and to investors, this is the kind of training we need. This is the kind of things that you can do. This is how we meet the demand of big data in this region and fulfill the promise, the objective of, you know, Northern Virginia being the big data capital of the world. A little bit more about the nvtc.org. This is, if you don't know, this is the basically organization that advocates and assists in collaborative initiatives among all the technology companies in the region and advocates to legislative bodies for the purposes of economic development for Virginia, but in particular Northern Virginia, right? And there's their motto, their mission over there. And one of their most popular and well-attended committees is the Big Data and Analytics Committee, started about 2 years ago. It's very active, meets a couple times monthly with the full team and individual, you know, subcommittees. And it's well represented in sponsorship and membership each month. And so one of the ways I would propose, if you're looking for a way to engage and get started in big data, if you're not already there, is check with your company or check individually, specifically with NBTC, and find, you know, a way to participate. Lots of opportunities to join, to volunteer, to attend events, et cetera. But this is a nexus of monthly big data activities and presentations and things happening. And their website is what you saw, nvtc.org. So how do you start? So I'm a student, maybe I'm a DBA, maybe I want to get into big data, I'm a systems engineer, I'm a web programmer, I want to get doing this, I want to be involved in all this. What do I do? Find a problem you'd like to address. Learn to help. That's what I always tell. I tell some of my interns this. What problem do you want to partake in? What are you challenged by? What kind of solutions do you want to take advantage of the collaborations and the research that go into fixing? Here's an example. The National Science Foundation has an initiative underway right now, just started last year, called the Big Data Regional Innovation Hubs. This is four regional collaborative efforts. We're in the southern region. They've got spoke initiatives that academic institutions, companies, agencies can collaborate on to propose projects that would get funding to help establish this universal, national, collaborative infrastructure for big data research and development. And some of the hub priority areas for our region, for the southern region, are things like social economic modeling, industrial big data, education, habitat planning. My favorite is it's the coastal hazards, natural and coastal hazards. That's a big part of the southern region. And so this is, in essence, getting collaborative assistance to address these challenges in our nation from everybody. To get engaged in something like this, ask the school you're at. Go to their website. Find out. There are ways to get involved in this, because by the next, you know, 1, 2, 3 years, there's going to be a lot of effort underway in this and a lot of projects that are going to be looking both for volunteer and research assistance. Some more ways to engage. So my brief advice is basically find or start, and there's plenty of startups out there, collaborative opportunities in this area. And these are just a few examples. And there are others, that are, you know, not easily found through networking or through Google. And so therefore, that's why the collaborative community comes into play, and that's why that's important. But things you can join, take a look at their website, find a way to get your company involved in that association, or if they already are, get on a committee or a special interest group or somewhere there, like the NBTC. ACT-IAC, okay, the dogs are coming down the aisle almost. I'll go a little bit faster. So ACT-IAC is is a local association of IT, basically company feedback in collaboration with the federal government. They're a federal big data summits from ATARC. Virginia Biotechnology Association just recently had a big data and clinical development. There's a lot of forums that you can get engaged in and get your company or your organization engaged at around Northern Virginia specifically. There's also a lot of user interest groups. Earlier, a fellow was talking about Java. Well, in this area, there is the oldest and largest Java users group out in Reston, and they talk about big data. Code for America, you know, a bunch of great civic hackers like our friend from Microsoft. They're doing a lot of fantastic work in leveraging the open data set APIs that the government's starting to surface and make available. And they talk about it, and projects come up within those brigades and within those meetups. If you go to meetups.com, type in big data, there's quite a bit out there, but here are a few of the major ones. There's the Nova Big Data Meetup, there's the Federal Big Data Working Group, Spark. Spark is an architectural processing layer basically on top of Hadoop. There's a meetup group that talks about what's going on in Spark. And these are all local, they're around here. Most are in Northern Virginia or DC or in this region. Obviously, universities and colleges. There's a, you know, GMU is the principal player in this space right now, I'd say. But many others are doing a lot of work as they are collaborating together in a lot of initiatives. Online, MOOCs, massively open online classes. Like if you go to bigdatauniversity.com, you want to find out what to learn and how to learn it and pieces and parts of the big data architecture, you can go and take classes in that. You can also go to resources from local technology companies like Oracle and find and see, you know, from very high abstraction to very low level detail, very good architectures of every facet of big data, from ingest to integration to visualization to security, storage, compute, the rest of it. Industry certificates and training. One last plug for data.virginia.gov. We've got a friend, and Anthony Fung is the associate, essentially CTO for the state of Virginia, and he's very active in NVTC and a lot of initiatives regarding big data and its advancement in the state of Virginia. And at the end of the day, it's all about jobs. I did a quick LinkedIn search for big data in this area. Got 2,700 jobs that have big data actually in the text and the name. So there are a lot of ways to do it, a lot of jobs to do. You kicking me off? Couple free tools, Oracle, Google, IBM, a lot of free tools out there to download. We have a virtual data, big data appliance that can be downloaded so you can run big data projects with all your Cloudera and Hadoop and security items right on your laptop. Here's some next steps to take a look at, and let's get out there and make this the big data capital of the world. Thank you.